Gunner Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now heavyweights, or cruiser slash heavyweights, Derek Chisora, the War Chisora, right? Not Dale Boy no more. He's War Chisora, who's been looking good of late. Got with his boy David Haye, got a little discipline. Has been looking good of late, Derek Chisora. He's got a fight lined up. It's coming whenever, you know, fighting starts again. With crowds. His promoter, David Haye, says he's going to need a crowd if they fight. But Derek Chisora is supposed to fight the next opponent for Oleksandr Usyk. And he said, listen, I'm going to have to adapt to Oleksandr Usyk. I'm going to have to adapt to his speed and the fact that he's just a good fighter. And but he thinks he'll be able to, you know, volume punch him and be able to bully him and try to get a win against Oleksandr Usyk. Now, this is pertinent because Oleksandr Usyk is boxing royalty. In terms of, you know, the man has been undisputed in the cruiserweight division. It's one of the most magnificent things you've seen in boxing in the last 5 years, for sure. Just because becoming undisputed, that would be enough, right, in boxing. Because whoever you like a lot hasn't done that. Some of the people who you like or not like a lot do things extra to not become that. Because to become undisputed, you can't say, hey, I'm not going to fight this guy. Or I'm not going to fight this guy. I'm going to wait till another one gets the belt and then fight them. All of that is out, right? Promoters and nothing can help you. You got to get all the belts. That means you have to go through everybody. And most of the guys, most of these real famous guys and the ones that are making the most money in boxing and all those things are not trying to become undisputed, right? And there's guys that they have to go through that are not that famous, but everyone knows they're dangerous because especially if you didn't beat them, then all of a sudden you're all of that. That's what boxing is doing all the time. It's just all the time. So Oleksandr Usyk is boxing royalty, in my opinion, period. He doesn't have to do whatever in the heavyweight division because in the cruiserweight division, he went to everyone's backyard to become undisputed cruiserweight champion. If it was Berlin, Marco Huck. If it was Latvia, Morris Brydis, who's still one of the baddest there. And if it was Russia, Murat Gassiev. Right, hard hitting Murat Gassiev, who was going to make some noise in the heavyweight division. Some things Murat Gassiev might even make more noise in the heavyweight division than Oleksandr Usyk, because Gassiev has puncher power going with him. Right, it's not all a skill thing. But well, Murat Gassiev got whitewashed and shut out in Russia, and he's Russian, so he had done that. Now, after becoming undisputed and going to everyone's backyard to do so. He went over to England to beat Tony Bellew, who was looking real good because he had beat David Haye twice. Bellew was feeling himself. And he went right over there, Liverpool or Manchester, and beat Tony Bellew. Now, prior to the tournament and going in there to beat everybody's backyard, he went to Poland to beat Glowacki, who was looking awesome. Glowacki had beat Marco Huck when it wasn't easy to do that. Marco Huck was actually ruling the cruiserweight division for a long time. Marco Huck got one record. I'm not sure. Title divisions, defenses or something. Marco Huck was looking good. After he lost to Glowacki, there was then a downside that came in. Then he lost to Usyk as well. But he went to Poland, where Glowacki's from, and beat him. So you're talking, let me just make sure this is clear. This is why Usyk is very important here. I got the title in the backyard of Glowacki, right? Entered the tournament to go to find out who the baddest cruiserweight is. So I go to Berlin to beat Marco Huck. That's his stomping grounds. I go to Latvia to beat Brightest. That's his stomping grounds. I go to Russia to beat Murat Gassiev. That's his stomping grounds when he's not training. And I go to whatever it was in England, Manchester or Liverpool, to beat Tony Bellew. That's his stomping grounds. Any fighter out there have done something even remotely close to that? Remotely. Because that means I was getting booed at the beginning of these fights. I won crowds over. I won. Only one of them fights was split decision. I think it was with your boy Morris Brydis in Latvia. You know, and if you win a split decision in somebody's hometown who was undefeated at the time, which was Morris Brydis was undefeated, so was Gassiev undefeated, then you have to really beat them. You ain't getting no split decisions in somebody's career if you didn't really beat them. So that's why whatever Derek Chisora's plan is, he understands that you're dealing with a formidable guy, a very strong-willed guy that is constantly not complaining about going home. I don't even know if he knows how to get to Ukraine no more. He don't even care if he fights home. He ain't even asking in negotiations. They're not being stopped for him asking, can we fight one in Ukraine or anywhere else that he wants to fight him? No, That's not a part of negotiation with Alexander Usyk. Where do you want to fight? That's what we're going to fight at. That's who he's asked all of his last opponents. Matter of fact, he beat Michael Hunter, which nobody else is doing, not even in the heavyweight division. You saw what just happened to Povetkin. They robbed Michael Hunter. He beat Povetkin, right? He's beating up all them big old heavyweights, you know, Ustinov, Maldonado, all them big old heavyweights, undefeated. One guy, Russian guy, forget his name, undefeated. Just beat him. All the guys, actually, Michael Hunter is making some big noise in the heavyweight division. Well, he was beat on American soil by Alexander Usyk, too, before the Golovkin fight. You see what I'm saying? That's ridiculous, Alexander Usyk. So that respect he's going to always have. The run that he's had right now will never be taken away. I don't care if he loses to Chisora and then goes and fight another heavyweight, losing him too. Don't matter. That run right there is something that's an anomaly. Period. He's a boxing anomaly. No one has that focus, that mindset. I'm going to everybody else's backyard. I'm going to beat them by enough where it's not going to matter where we're boxing at. That's incredible. So, yes, your boy Derek Chisora, if he gets a win over Alexander Usyk, even though Usyk's a little bit smaller, doesn't matter. It would be a very good win for Derek Chisora in the fight. You know, I really never liked Chisora until when you get late in your career, I'm going to like you. Don't really matter who you are because it's late in your career and you're an underdog at this point. But in this fight, it doesn't really matter because I'm definitely pulling for Ukraine bringing the pain, Alexander Usyk, because it's something really ridiculously special what you're seeing there. Right, because he's not like this heavy hitter, right? He's not like a one-punch heavy hitter. He just systematically breaks you down and beats you up at the end of the day, and that's also awesome. So that fight is something to look forward to. It's not going to be an easy fight for either one of these fighters, but it's going to be very significant, especially when you get a chance to look at Alexander Usyk. You're going to be like, the highlights, he's pretty good. How is he winning like that? Because he's really damn good, right? We ain't going to go through the names again. You just go through his record and see when the last time the dude's been at home. It's been ridiculous. So, yeah, that's be very interesting to see what happens with Derek Chisora if he's able to tame this guy, Alexander Usyk. Will be awesome to see, too. Let's see what happens. Done with Sports Talk Worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.